Good morning, students. Yesterday we discussed the error of sum and the error of difference. Today we are going to discuss the error of product. That is, if two physical quantities are in the product form that is dependent on another, that is third physical quantity. So how to find the error in the physical quantity that is dependent on the product of the two physical quantities. So let us suppose that A and B, again the two physical quantities which is dependent on the third physical quantity Z in the form of product, that is A into B. For example, the area of a rectangle is this length and through breadth. So this length and breadth, the two physical quantity in the form of product, that is dependent on this area, third physical quantity. So whatever length you measure or breadth you measure, there might be some error in these measurements. So these errors will propagate in the measurement of the area. The error in the area you don't measure directly. It is propagated due to the error committed in the measurement of length and breadth. So here let us suppose that plus, as earlier, plus minus delta A, the error, absolute error in measurement of A, and plus minus delta B, the absolute error in the measurement of B. So obviously in the measurement of Z there will be some error, and that error let us suppose plus minus delta Z. So including these errors, if we write equation 1, then we can have Z plus minus delta Z is equal to A plus minus delta A into B plus minus delta B. Now if you open the bracket, so we will find out A into B plus minus A delta A into B, that is plus minus B delta A, and this A into plus minus delta B plus minus A into delta B. So this we can write as Z plus minus delta Z is equal to this. Now from equation 1, this A plus A into B is equal to Z, so we can write it further as Z plus minus delta Z is equal to Z plus minus B delta A plus minus A delta B, and one more term will be there, that is plus minus delta A into delta B. Now this plus minus A delta A into delta B, it is very very small quantity and we can ignore it, because this delta A, that is error, it comes out of the order of 0.0001, for example, centimeter length you measure, and suppose delta B, it is 0.00005 centimeter. So product delta A into delta B, it becomes 0.00005 square centimeter, which is a very small quantity, so we can neglect this one. So this becomes 0 and we are left with this only. Now here Z can be cancelled out, so you are left with plus minus delta Z is equal to plus minus B delta A plus minus A delta B. So the maximum error in the measurement of Z can be written as this B delta A plus A delta B, ignoring the negative sign, because when we calculate the maximum error, so we ignore all the negative sign. Now this was the absolute error in the measurement of this physical quantity Z due to the errors propagated in the measurement of A and B. Now you want to calculate the relative error in the measurement of Z. So divided by Z and we will get what? Delta Z upon Z is equal to divide the whole equation by Z. So we will get delta Z by Z. Delta B delta A plus A delta B upon AB, because Z is equal to AB also. Now this, open this one, so we will get delta Z upon Z is equal to this B delta A upon AB plus A delta B upon AB. So this B is cancelled out here, this A is cancelled out, and we are left with delta Z upon Z is equal to delta A upon A plus delta B upon B. So this is the absolute error in the measurement of Z. This is the relative error in the measurement of Z, which is the sum of the relative error in the measurement of A and the relative error in the measurement of Z. But if you want to determine the percentage error in the measurement of Z, then multiply it by 100. So delta Z by Z into 100 is equal to delta A upon A into 100 plus delta B upon B into 100. So what is this? This is percentage error in Z is equal to percentage error in A plus percentage error in B. That is percentage error. In terms of percentage error, how can we say percentage error in the measurement of Z is equal to the sum of percentage error in A plus and the sum of, and the percentage error in B. So this was the error of product. Now next we are going to discuss the error of the quotient. Now fourth one, that is the error of quotient. Error of quotient. So again let us suppose that there are two physical quantities A and B that is dependent on the third physical quantity, suppose Z, in the form of quotient, that is A divided by B. Suppose there are two physical quantities A and B which are dependent on Z in the form of division. For example, the density is equal to mass upon volume. So this density is dependent on this physical quantity mass, that is divided by another physical quantity volume. So if you have a formula like this and you are going to measure this physical quantity like mass and volume, then you might commit some mistake or error in the measurement of mass and the volume, and that error will propagate in the measurement of the density. So here suppose that plus minus again delta A is the absolute error in the measurement of A, and plus minus delta B is the absolute error in the measurement of B. So these errors will propagate in Z. So plus minus, suppose delta Z is the error in the measurement, is propagated in the physical quantity Z. Now with these errors we can write Z plus equation 1 can be written as Z plus minus delta Z is equal to A plus minus delta A upon B plus minus delta B. This can also be written as A plus minus delta A into B plus minus delta B to the power minus 1, Z plus minus delta Z. Now let us take out the A and B in these brackets, A and B from these brackets. So we can write this equation as z plus minus delta z is equal to a inside bracket you are left with 1 plus minus delta a upon a into b to the power, when you take the outside, so you have the power minus 1, so here minus 1 power will be to the power minus 1, and inside the bracket 1 plus minus delta b upon b to the power minus 1. Now this can be written as what? This a and b to the power minus 1 means a upon b. Now we are left with 1 plus minus delta a upon a into 1 plus minus delta b upon b to the power minus 1. Now I have sent you the mathematical tools. In that mathematical tools there is a formula on binomial theorem. Binomial theorem, according to binomial theorem, 1 plus x to the power n, when we expand this, so we get 1 plus n x plus n n minus 1 upon 2 x to the power 2 plus n n minus 1 n minus 2 upon 6 x cube plus so on. It goes up to nth term. So in this formula we have n terms. So here this bracket is somewhat like this bracket. If we put x is equal to delta b upon b, so comparing with this relation, here n will be equal to minus 1. Now if x is very very small, then this formula can be approximated to 1 plus x to the power n, can be written equivalent to, not exactly equal to, can be approximated to 1 plus nx. 1 plus nx, and we ignore the higher order terms. Why? If x is very small, its square will be a very small quantity, its cube will be further very small quantity, for example 0.001, suppose it is x, so its square, x is suppose 0.001, so its square will be 0.000001, and its cube will have so many zero after the decimal. So the higher order terms are very very small, whose contribution to first two terms is negligible, so we can neglect the higher order terms. Now so in our case also delta b is very small, further divided by b makes it further smaller, therefore in our case also this x, which is equal to delta b upon b, is very small quantity, and n is equal to here in our case minus 1. So if we use this formula here, so this becomes z plus minus delta z is equal to a upon b inside bracket this 1 plus minus delta a upon a, and this becomes what? 1, and this nx, so n here plus here minus 1, and x is n here minus 1, and x is equal to delta b upon b. Now when we simplify this, so we get z plus minus delta z is equal to this a upon b, we can write equal to z from equation 1. Now this is equal to 1 plus minus delta a upon a and here plus minus this 1 plus minus delta b upon b, or you can write minus plus, it doesn't matter, you have both the sign. Now when you open this, so what we get, 1 plus minus this delta a into delta a upon a into 1 into 1, so 1 you get here, now delta a upon a into 1, so delta a upon a. Now this delta a upon a multiplied by delta b upon b, so you get plus minus delta a upon a into delta b upon b, and then this 1 multiplied by this delta b upon b, so minus plus delta b upon b. Now as earlier, this delta a and delta b are very small quantities, so their product is a further smaller quantity, so this quantity can be neglected, that will become 0, and you are left with z plus minus delta z is equal to z inside bracket 1 plus minus delta a upon a, and this minus plus delta b upon b. Now if you open the bracket, so we can write z plus minus delta z is equal to this z, or we divide, you can divide it by z, instead of opening it, so z plus minus delta z upon z is equal to z upon z 1 plus minus delta a upon a minus plus delta b upon b. So this will be cancelled here, and here you get 1 plus minus delta z upon z is equal to 1 plus minus delta a upon a minus plus delta b upon b. Now this 1 is cancelled out on both sides, this 1 is cancelled on both sides, and you are left with delta z plus minus delta z upon z is equal to plus minus delta a upon a plus minus plus delta b upon b. Now for maximum error, we know that we take only positive side, so we write delta z upon z is equal to delta a upon a plus delta b upon b. So this is the relative error in the measurement of this physical quantity z, which is dependent on the two other physical quantities a and b. Now absolute error in the measurement of this z, we can write delta z is equal to, take this z on the right hand side, so delta a upon a plus delta b upon b into z. So this will be the absolute error in the measurement of z when the two physical quantities are dependent on z in the form of quotient. Now to find the percentage error, multiply this one by 100. So delta z by z into 100 is equal to delta a by a into 100 plus delta b upon b into 100. So this is the percentage error in the measurement of z is equal to the sum of percentage error in the measurement of a and the measurement of b. So you observe that you get the same equations as you have obtained in case of the product. So for the calculation of product or the quotient, you get the similar formula. Okay, thank you.